Greetings and salutations, tube-farers. This is your host, the Mad Bag, with another Mad Bag Gamer production. Another Thieves Guild quest, Hard Answers. This quest begins immediately after speaking to Carlia outside of the Snowvale Sanctum. And I think, if I remember correctly, this is kind of one of the longer quests. If it turns out to be too long, I might have to split it into a couple parts. I might be remembering it wrong, though. It might have some other quest that starts, like, midway through it that I just don't remember technically being a separate quest. So, the quest is to get a hold of someone in Winterhold, in the College of Winterhold, who can identify the code that Gallus' journal is written in. So, I'm gonna go to Winterhold. It looks like, my objective may be in the inn. Let's take a look at Inthir's schedule. So, Inthir is a College of Winterhold personnel. He's a member of the College of Winterhold. However, he doesn't always spend his time in the college. Sometimes you can find him in the inn, which means if you haven't done the annoying attunement quest, or whatever you want to call it, to allow you into the college, you have to go up and talk to this Feralda chick right up here. She requires that you cast a certain spell in front of her. The spell that you have to cast is random and dependent on your level. Depending on your level when you talk to her, I should say. So if you go up there in the early game, you can potentially have to cast a lower level spell. So that might be something good to do with all new characters. However, Inthir is not always in there, so you don't have to go into the college for this quest. You can come to the inn, and if he's not in the inn, you can wait here in about, I would say, 4-hour increments.
Empire's in charge now.
He's here for longer than a 4-hour period, so you can wait about 4 hours, and eventually he'll pop up. You won't miss him that way. Hello, Inthir.
Can I help you with anything else?
Anything else? I don't remember what this character's spoken to him about. Maybe about discerning the transmundane or something, I don't recall. I have been sent by Carlia.
Carlia? Then she's finally found it. Do you have Gallus' journal?
What? How does he know about this? That seems like a mistake on Carlia's part. Yes, but there's a problem.
A problem? Let me see it. Oh, this is just like Gallus. A dear friend, but always too clever for his own good. He's written all of the text in the Falmer language.
Can you translate it?
No. However, I know someone who might. The court wizard of Markarth, Calselmo, may have the materials you need to get this journal
Markarth
translated. Word of warning. Calselmo is a fierce guardian of his research. Getting the information won't be easy.
What exactly is a farmer? I know, but I'll ask.
In the time before man, they were known as the Snow Elves. They lived in the sunlight and had a very prosperous society.
So they were like your kind?
Like the Altmer? Yes, I would say their culture quite possibly rivaled our own.
Rivaled? What drove them underground?
The Nords went to war with the Falmer in the First Era. Killed them by the thousands to drive them from their snowy homeland. The Falmer retreated underground and forged an uneasy alliance with the Dwarves who ended up betraying them. This betrayal made them what they are now. Horrible, blind monstrosities with a burning hatred of any but their own kind.
They are monstrosities, too. They sound more like victims to me.
Yes, I suppose you're right. Forgive me. I've lost several close friends to the Falmer, and it tends to distort my view. If you wish to learn more about them, you're welcome to my tome on the subject. Should be on my table.
I wonder if that would help at all. What can you tell me about Gallus?
He was a dear friend of mine, and a surprisingly astute pupil of academia. Devastated when he was killed. I suppose that risk always coexisted with his line of work. I just never thought his luck would run out.
Huh. Interesting. The reference to luck constantly. He was an academic, yet he chose a different path. Why?
For the thrill, of course. He was quite clear that he felt more in his element climbing through a window rather than hunched over a dusty tome.
How did you meet him?
Ah, yes. Quite an amusing anecdote, actually. I caught him trying to break into my laboratory. I was about to show him the error of his ways when he made a curiously astute comment about my research notes. I was astounded and in turn led to a conversation. Who'd have imagined it would lead to such a strong friendship?
Why did Gallus scribe his journal in Farmer?
Besides the fact that there are only a handful of people in Tamriel that even recognize the language, I'm fairly certain he was planning some sort of a heist that involved a deep understanding of the Falmer language.
Sadly,
we never had the opportunity to speak about the details.
Where did he acquire the knowledge to use it?
Ironically, I pointed him in the same direction I pointed you, to Markarth and Kalselmo.
Huh.
I'm only hoping whatever means he used to learn the language will still be available to you.
So Kalselmo may have directly helped him. Okay,
Kalselmo is,
I think I'm going to poke through
mule.
This book real fast, just
to
see if there's anything useful in there. I don't really expect there to be, and I'm not going to record it, so... tick! Okay, so that was a book about solitude and nothing else. That's silly. I bet his dialogue referred to his room. Did he say desk or did he say dresser? I think he might have said dresser, in which case it would probably be the dresser that's in his room in the College of Winterhold. I'm not going to go that far. Just to see if there might be some juicy morsel of information. I'm not that dogged in my determination towards finding every little bit of info. So let's head straight on over to Markarth. It looks like I've never been to the Understone Keep in Markarth with this character. Because if I had visited this before, I would have been able to travel straight to it on my map, as I'm sure I can now.
You disrespect me.
So let's see about this Kalselmo.
What are you hiding?
Boy, there's quests just trying to pop off all over the place and get me started on them. I happen to know that Kalselmo gives a side quest that, and actually let me look at a little something about that quest. Okay, so this is the way it works. If you do the side quest for him, he will give you access to the museum. I have to eventually reach a laboratory within the museum. So getting through the museum helps because it's locked off if I haven't completed that quest. However, it's not necessarily required, and it's possible I can get into it another way. Now, the other way is to persuade him.
What are you doing here? The excavation site is closed. I don't need any more workers or guards.
I was looking for you, actually, Kalselmo.
I told you I'm not hiring any more guards. Why do you people always bother me when I'm trying to finish my research?
Cal.
You idiot. Do you even know who I am? The most recognized scholar on the Dwemer in all of Tamriel.
No.
And you people keep bothering me. I'm sorry, I got too excited. I'm in the middle of some very stressful work, and I shouldn't have yelled. How can I help you?
It's all right, don't sweat it. I heard you're the authority on ancient Falmer.
Then you were well informed. I am at this very moment on the cusp of completing my magnum opus on the subject. I'm calling it Kalselmo's Guide to the Falmer Tongue. It will revolutionize the way we understand those ancient beings.
Perhaps I could view your work?
Preposterous. That research represents years of personal toil in some of the most dangerous Dwemer ruins in Skyrim. You must be mad to think I'd allow anyone to see it before it's completed.
Okay, so the bribe and the intimidate always fail here, and then I can say forget it and leave. The persuasion will give me access to the museum, just like completing the side quest first with Kalselmo will do. I can pick my way into the museum, I think, which is probably what this character will have to end up doing, because I don't have a real high speechcraft. But I'm going to try the persuade. Also note that if you go get an Amulet of Debella and get the blessing, I'm at like 60 speechcraft. If you're even this high, that will almost assuredly give you the persuasion. So let's try it.
While I appreciate the sentiment, I still have to decline.
Yes, of course.
Being an admirer, I'm sure you can appreciate the need to keep my research a secret.
Yeah, ultimately I can. Forget it. Maybe I'll come back later.
Very well. Perhaps when my research is complete, I'll feel more comfortable discussing my findings.
Yeah, certainly. Although, people in my guild will be dead. Okay, it says optional. Obtain the key to Kalselmo's museum. And there's actually a key right there. Okay. Wow, that's easy. I don't remember it being that easy. I think when I went through this before, I had already done the side quest for him, so none of this was pertinent. Dwemer Museum Key, if I can get it again. Come on. Not the scrap metal museum key. Snatch. Okay, well, I got the museum key right there from the table anyway, so I didn't have to do any of that. shenaniganry, the side quest, or have good speechcraft. Okay, well, let's check out the museum. I think it's straight across. Is that right? Hard answers. I don't want anything miscellaneous checked. Yeah, okay, so the miscellaneous was out the front door. It's still in the keep, as I thought it was.
The Dwemer Museum isn't open to anyone without the court wizard's permission.
Dwemer Museum?
It means Dwarven Museum. Lost race of people that built this city. You want to know more? Ask Calcimo. He's usually in front of the ruins, just down the tunnel.
Okay, well, that's weird. So he doesn't technically give me access yet.
Sudden moves. Understood.
So it looks like not only are the previous two aforementioned ways of gaining access to the museum the only two that allow you to pass this guard with ease, but not having done those is also going to give me a little bit of other trouble. And that's going to start the second I get inside here. So you guys are going to have to see Naked Red Guard here for a second. And I'm not sure this is even going to work anyway. Nope. Straight to detected. Let's just see if, yeah, he's going to be cool with me right here. Then he's not going to be able to see me. So he hasn't yelled at me quite yet. I'm going to go all the way against the back wall because I think his cone of vision might be just big enough to get this door. If I can get over to the door, though, I've got the key to get in it. Alright, so now let's explore the next part of what's going to be a pain in the butt for me. And that's going to be getting through this section. So, there are a couple guards in here, and they are Markarth City guards, so killing them will have a huge bounty. It's like 3,000 gold.
There must be a dozen men up there.
I can hear them talking already.
Calcelmo called in his entire expedition team. Said he needed every man he could get to protect his research.
This is probably going to be real pertinent.
We lost three good men to the traps. And for what? Just to see another damn spider clanking around? Well, at least this post is safe enough. Come on, let's get back to work.
Oh boy. So all the guards are down here from the expedition. I happen to know that this museum that I'm in right now you can get to throughout at any point in time, whether you're on this quest or not. However, the laboratory that I continue into as part of this quest is only accessible during this quest. So if you don't check it out now, check everything about it out now, you won't be able to see it later. And I don't know that I'm going to be able to make it through here. I bet I get a bounty just for being caught here. I'm going to continue walking because, again, my sneak is horrible. And I expect my sneak to be leveling up any second. Alright, I have a guard going up over there. I have a guard standing facing the other direction. And I have a guard across the hall that I don't think is going to see me. However, that guard does see me.
Order of the ox. Oh, no.
Five bounty added to the reach. You caught me. I'll pay the bounty. Unfortunately, I might have some stolen stuff.
Smart,
I hope not.
Man. Now. Come along with us. We'll take any stolen goods, and you'll be free to go. After you pay the fine, of course.
Alright, here we go. To the keep. So, just another Naked Red Guard out in the middle of Markarth. Out of the museum. I have an idea, I think. Yeah. That's all I need to put on. I always trick myself, taking off just my armor, because normally when I do anything with like all my gear, I take off rings and necklaces too. And whenever I'm trying to sneak with this character, and this is the only character I've done it with, when I take all my armor off, I'm always thinking, now I gotta put it all back on, and it's more than four pieces. But nope, it's just four pieces.
Someone stole you.
Always feels like too few. So my idea is that I think I'm gonna try to charge in, and I happen to know that the men in the laboratory are not city guards. They are Calcimo's men specifically. So, if I can manage to just trailblaze my way through this section, then I'll be able to kill everybody else. Horrible way to think of it as a thief, but that's how I'm going to think of it. Actually, I had my Whirlwind Sprint Shout loaded because I figured it might be useful, but I think instead I'm going to try to just use Fusro Da if any of them get close to me. I'll probably just use one word of it just to knock them down. I don't want to like fling a guard off and kill him. And if I can, I'd like to get through here with like just the 5 bounty. Oh! Okay, here we go. Actually, he's coming to attack me instantly. I didn't even say, no, I won't come with you. He just said, no, look, second offense, you're trying to get in here and we're going to kill you. So hopefully they will not follow me beyond these doors. I got to lockpick them anyway. Boy, this would be absolutely impossible if I had a couple guards shooting arrows at me from behind. Lockpicking level up, and I'm hidden again instantly, which means they do not follow. I'm going to take a chance and do just a touch of spell casting there. I think that's right. Yeah, that's right. Yeah, put those away. We don't need those yet, however, we likely will very soon. Okay, so that door marks the point in which I am now in a quest unique area. I can never get back into this area until I'm done with the quest. Kill any intruders on site, I just heard. That is likely not a good thing. Okay, so this journal, check it. I'm not going to read the whole thing, but it basically goes through an apprentice of Calcimo's experience controlling a spider. So I'm going to steal this spider control rod. And the spider's going to pop out, and he's going to start listening to me. And I'm going to shove a control rod in a place that one of these guards don't like it. And actually, I think they come patrolling into this room here in a second, if I remember correctly. That looks like a valve that I could use to maybe gas the place, or maybe spit fire out on that gas. I'm going to be a bit meticulous about getting loot throughout this section. Oh, I can't pick that lock. That must be the end. I'm going to be a bit meticulous about getting loot through this section, as I can never return to it. Check that out. I ordered the spider to attack him. Let's see what this does. Fire? Fire? No. Arrows. From where? What the crap is going on with the arrows? Okay, I'm just going to come out of the woodwork here. I believe... Oh, I'm not sneaking now. I was getting ready to say, I believe I'm technically still sneaking. Alright. Oh! Looks like the power attack does work even if I'm sneaking, which is good. Laboratory key. That may be useful. Let's keep that. I bet I lost the museum key that I had. Holy crap. My attack blew the spider up, so I guess I don't get to use that a whole lot anymore. Or at all. I guess that means I should probably get rid of the staff. Yeah, 30 armor. I may not keep looting these guards down here. If it's only 30 armor. I was looking at that piece of armor. 30 gold. I'm not sure looting each one of these guys is going to be worth the 30 gold. Whoa, do I have a weird spell on that? I do. I had healing on my left hand. That is not ideal. I'm going to do this just to, Oh. Okay. So spikes on that side. This place is rigged with all kinds of crazy traps, huh? No. Nobody's here. You don't see anybody. Sneak increased. All right, here we go. I'm going to get a power attack. I'm going to get a stealth. Oh, sneak attack. 3x damage. That feels good. Boy, if my sneak was good, this character would be amazing. Arrow doesn't get me. Sneak attack goes right through the shield. Arrow still, don't you know? I'm that guy. I'm that guy that you can't hit with arrows. Haven't you heard of that guy? Oh, and by the way, if I scream at you, you die. Your head explodes. In a fountain of fluid red. Alright. Let's get the nooks and crannies. This looks like food storage oriented. Check the end table, and it's actually stealing. I wonder if I'll get bounty from not being sneak. Yeah, okay, I didn't. Good. Nobody's around to see the dirty deed. So I don't necessarily have to sneak if the place is empty anyway. I'm going to check this area out, though, because I want them loots. Anything, like I was getting ready to say, food item or, like, storage looking, I probably won't go through everything there. Boy, there are laboratory keys all over this place. Like, all over. Nightshade. I would normally snatch those, but I don't want to steal them because they'll technically be sitting in my inventory as a stolen item, and that's goofy. I won't be able to sell them if I so choose, even though they're ingredients, and I probably wouldn't sell them anyway. Those scrolls, I'm not going to pick them up just to sell them, even though I'm getting a couple fences. Maybe I could stop looking at stolen items that way. Maybe I could start making regular fence visits, although that's kind of a pain in its own right. Requires that precious time!
Think this is?
Oh boy, there's not gonna be any sneaking there. I bumbled. like too much of a buffoon. And now they have to die. I like how these guys are specifically called wizard guards. Or wizard's guards. And the way it is the way it's written is it's like multiple wizards. These guards protect multiple wizards. It's like the wizard's guard. That's funny. If the apostrophe were on this side of the S, it would be like wizards. Like it's his, like it's Calcimo's guards. But no, this is just the troop of guards that protects up the wizards. They specialize in wizard protection. Ooh, a master chest. I'm gonna just go ahead and chop this from the start. Because it's not gonna take me very long at all to get. It was basically straight up. Okay, whatever. Well, there's the loots from it anyway. I know that there's a way. These are blades. You can activate this trap and it probably would have wiped out all these guards. I know there's a way to, I just don't perfectly recall where it is. Or see. Switch. There was a lever somewhere. Where was that lever at? I swear I was fighting a guy right next to a lever just a second ago. Okay, maybe not. Carrying on. Let me take a quick glance at my map. Ooh, looks like a big area. That looks pretty cleared out. This side down over here doesn't, and that's where I'm going. Okay. So I'll be doing good to continue to... Actually, maybe this hasn't been cleared out. This probably goes to a new section. Ah, it does. Vigorous potion of healing. What do we have here? A lever that removes the gas. So without that lever being pressed... Yeah, I'm taking damage. There's dangerous gas down here. Guard? I wonder what a guard's doing. Oh, check that out. Okay. So there's a couple down in here, too. For a second, I was getting ready to say, I bet I gotta drag a guard body over to that lever. But I don't think that's the case, actually. They actually set me up to get through it. This way. Don't let the gas out. Oh my god, I'm gonna die. That didn't sound very... Oh, Amulet of Dabella. If I would have had that when I was talking to, Calcimo, maybe it would have been a different story. Wow, this is some potentially serious business, though. I bet it would be difficult to get through this whole thing without using these switches at all. And funny enough, I think I did that with my archer. She had a whole bunch of, like, poison resistance things, though. This really wasn't crap to her. Neither were the Charis poisons. Charis poisons weren't anything to her. She's a wood elf. That gives her a 50% right off the bat. That poison's kind of serious, though. As I continue to spam my 2 low-level healing spell. I can't believe I'm still using that healing spell. I need to get the next one. I'm going to activate it because I think this is for a trap. Ah, check this out. I dare guards to be... Oh, hold on. I actually just came back up. So, wait a second. Where did I first come in here from? Maybe this is the other side of that thing. I think it is, actually. Okay, that makes a little bit more sense. Yes, here we go. So going up is going to be progression. Going down was just a little detour into some non-loots, really. There wasn't really crap down there for me.
Back up! I need some help in here!
Oh, he did not go down because my first two did not hit him. And I hate having to use 2 power attacks on one guard. That's so bogus.
Now is someone there?
Woohoo, use a little sprinting. I'll use a little sprinting before I have to use a power attack. Oh! I critical striked the guy with the shield. Oh, if I can get you both. It would have been so great if I could have got both those archers with that strain of power attacks. Oh, fatality. That was on a power attack, too. That made it extra sweet. I was expecting just a big hit. Nope. It was a big fatality hit. These guards are almost not worth this 30 gold. It's right on. Just right on the edge of me still wanting to bend down and pick it up. You really wouldn't think so, but bending down to pick up a little bit of something or maybe a couple items off every dead body you pass really lengthens the amount of time it takes you to do one of these things. And I am one that, especially when I'm playing off camera, I pick up everything. I go through absolutely everything. I don't pick up the scrap metal. That is, unless I just now got the Dwemer smithing perk and I'm trying to level it up. Then it's really useful because you can boil all that down. Oh boy. Hey, I got a chance to sneak for a second. And hey, check it out, another trap. I bet this one does something specific. Can I tell? I don't know, I can't see much. I'm just gonna hit it. Oh! Holy... Whoa.
No, this can't be happening. You need to leave now.
I think I'm going to just push him down into the blades. Oh, he didn't go into the blades. Maybe I can stay in front of him and keep him from running back this way. Get him to kind of chop himself up. I hope. Come on back. Ain Kantar? I think that's Calcimo's apprentice. It was his journal that I found that said something about the spider control rod. I don't think I can steal anything else while, hold on. He's a dead body, so that's not technically stealing. Even though I'm the one that killed him. Oh, that's so goofy. I can't pick anything up. What? He died? Yes! Harvest his blood. Sweet! I love your encounter. A key to another area. I'll take it. Could come in handy later. Way later, maybe. And I'm gonna have to get out of the way of this blade right now. Woohoo! Okay, now there's nobody in here, I can steal these items without getting bounty. If he would have been alive telling me that I needed to leave when I picked up those crystals, it would have technically given me bounty, even though he probably would have ended up dying either way. Books? What's this one? Chimera minivan? Minivan! It's a Chimera's minivan. Okay, nope. I don't know, and I'm not going to try to say it for real because I got a cat in my face. I had to pause real fast. He is normally real good about not getting on my desk, and I do have a pretty stern hand about making sure he doesn't, but every now and then my little scuddy buddy jumps up there anyway. Oh, the Dwemer puzzle cube, so I'm glad I came up here and looked. Right before going out to the wizard's balcony, off here to the right side, because the wizard's balcony is right there, off here to the right side is this Dwemer puzzle cube, which is yet another larceny target. Yes. Okay, so what does this go down to? I bet this goes down to the... Whoa, gotta go through the door, not on the other side of it. Okay, yep. This goes down to the original area. The exit, essentially, back out to the museum. So that's where I will likely return. Let's go out to the balcony. And see what we find in the far reaches. A seeming dead end. Yep, pretty sure that's a dead end. And I now overlook... Wow, I overlooked just about all. That's the temple. I think that's the temple of Dabella, is that right? Or is that Mara? I don't remember which one it is in here in Markarth. That looks suspicious. Ooh, it looks so suspicious. I can just see where it cuts off. But this looks... Oh no. Okay, I'm still good. Going into the waterfall, that looked really suspicious. I was expecting a chest. We've got some high ground. I think I might not end up going back through the museum to escape. Ooh, the tower! Calcell's Tower. I wonder if I'm back to Markarth guards or if it's still these special, I don't know, like assassin guards, the wizard's guards, the guards of the wizards. I don't know. I think actually maybe nobody, especially since I killed his apprentice. Maybe nobody? Aha, his room, his own personal office. This should be where the highest quality of the loots are for this quest. There's that, actually this one has a different value. Oh, check that out. So the name of this book I even joked about not being able to say, I think. Maybe there's a character or two different in that. And downstairs it was nothing. I picked it up, it was 20 value. It didn't give me anything. Up here it gives me heavy armor. It's a 70 value book, that's what tipped me off. So I've got a lot of random stuff around here. A lot of drawings, a lot of their metal, of course. Dwarven metal. I'm sure Calcimo has a huge interest in that. Ooh, potions. Charcoal and rolls of paper. All the livelong day. An expert chest. Give me a try. I'm already getting some. Oh. I went a little too far right, I think. Maybe just try it. Didn't move it at all. Right open. That master that I just did a second ago is basically just like that, too. I cut the camera off, cut it right back on. Wow. So he has reconstructed, at least in outer appearance, an entire new dwarven machine. That's kind of cool. Gotta give him some props for that. Alright, what do we got out here for an objective? Just another loose door. Calcelmo's stone. Don't see any chests out here. You don't have the items required to make a copy of the inscription. duplicate the writing on the stone. Okay, well, if this isn't a bit of foreshadowing, I don't know what is. I'm going to take a roll of paper. I'm going to take a piece of charcoal. Let me see. I think the quest log even says something like that. Duplicate it. Okay, yeah. Yep. Here we go. Peek-a-bam. Charcoal removed, roll of paper removed, calcimo stone rubbing added. And what do we have over here? Guards coming in.
Adriel, what a day.
Let me try. I really, 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 really don't want to fight a whole bunch more people. I want to be a sneak thief like I should be. And it's working? Question mark? Question mark? Question mark? I think it is. I think it's working. They didn't leave a guy behind? I don't think they left anybody behind. Oh no, let me take the walking off real fast. Hey, look at that, I'm even gonna be like a like an Assassin's Creed sneaker about it. I'm like free running around the rooftops. And back out, specifically to the rooftops. Now, normally I think I'd go back in there, but I think I'm not gonna do that. I think I'm just going to escape. Oh hey, check it out, it even gives me an objective here. What does it say? What does it say to do here? Return to Inther. That can't possibly be where it means. Why is that objective there? I don't want to jump. I'm going to die if I jump here. Hold on. There we go. There we go. Oh, check that out. It's basically a walkway. It's basically a walkway going down. I bet it even goes a little further. Maybe it goes right over here. Yeah. Well, that's really easy. Junipers. Sure, I'll take all that. And the egg. What about the egg? I think I'm fine. On some level ground. Well, that was an easy escape anyway. You know what? From that balcony, I bet I could have fast-traveled. I don't know why I even went through all that. I guess it was fun to cliffhang a little? Do a little mountain climbing? Indeers, who I'm supposed to return to. I don't think this is over quite yet. When enemies are nearby. Enemies are nearby? What do you mean, when enemies are nearby? I bet some of those guards saw me on the way out. I'm going to go try to leave Markarth real quick. I'm just going to run right out the front gate. Holy crap, okay, so the second I stepped out of Markarth, I'm getting attacked. Oh, it's a Vigilant. What's going on here? Vigilant Tyrannus? No, when did I get in battle with him? That's the dude for the House of Horrors. I hope he just goes unconscious and doesn't die. He reflects a Daedric quest. Okay, nope, he can't die. That's good. Weird that he attacked me. Okay, well, that was the enemy nearby. Okay, let's travel to Winterhold. Okay, okay, okay. Okay. Nope, not Dawnstar. Winterhold. Inther, being a hound doggy, still in the inn. That makes me wonder if maybe it's not on a cycle, but it's just for this quest.
The empire, but we get to stay.
The basement? The Frozen Hearth cellar. Ah, here we are. Inther, ooh, and Carlia. Check that out.
Hey, and how was our friend Calcelmo?
Calcelmo was great. There is. This should help translate Gallus' journal.
I suppose it would be inappropriate of me to ask how you obtained this. So
these charcoal paper rubbings?
A rubbing, eh?
Ooh, it's a rubbing, yes. Yes, a rubbing.
Notes.
It's quite the tale.
I understand. Now, let me take a good look at this. Over here, please.
Do I have to be here? It's probably going to take you a while to use a rubbing to translate an entire journal, unless you're just like, I don't know, you're Johnny Five. Read a whole book by just flipping through the pages very, very quickly.
Highly disturbing.
What is it in there?
Gallus had suspicions about Mercer Frey's allegiance to the guild for months. Gallus had begun to uncover what he calls an unduly lavish lifestyle replete with spending vast amounts of gold on personal pleasures.
Does the journal say where this
sounds like the leader
from?
Of any organization anywhere,
yes,
as far
Gallus
as I'm concerned.
Seems certain that Mercer had been removing funds from the guild's treasury without anyone's knowledge.
Anything else, Enther? Anything about the Nightingales?
Yes, here it is. The last few pages seem to describe the failure of the Nightingales, although it doesn't go into great detail.
Failure.
Gallus also repeatedly mentions his strong belief that Mercer desecrated something known as the Twilight Sepulchre.
Shadows preserve us. So it's true.
I
I'm not familiar with the Twilight Sepulchre. What is it? What's Mercer Frey done?
Something heinous from the sounds of it.
I can't say. All that matters is we deliver your translation to the guild immediately.
Immediately!
Words can't express.
It's all right, Carlia. You don't have to say a word.
She's getting all teary-eyed over Gallus, over the memory of Gallus. Speak to Inthir, eh? Okay.
Listen. All I want is the truth to be revealed to the guild. They respected Carlia, and she deserves better.
Oh, okay.
Do whatever you can, and I'd consider it a personal favor.
Okay, it makes a little bit more sense that Inthir knows about Carlia and knows about the situation, and that she's separate from the guild. Maybe he hasn't had dealings with the guild himself since this all went down. Thank you, Inthir.
If trying to rid yourself of stolen goods becomes
and here's my Winterhold
fence.
Find
yourself in Winterhold, visit me at the college.
Yeah, certainly.
I've been known to handle items of questionable interest from time to time, and I'll see what I can do.
What a fancy way of saying your offense.
If you have further need of me, you can find me in the college.
Yeah, certainly. I won't. Hello, Carlia. Gallus's journal mentioned the Twilight Sepulchre.
You've come this far, so I see no harm in concealing it any longer. The Twilight Sepulchre is the temple to Nocturnal.
You mean not concealing
it's
it?
It's what the Nightingales are sworn to protect Nocturnal. With their lives.
Why does it require your life to protect it?
Everything that represents Nocturnal's influence is contained within the walls of the Sepulchre. Now it seems Mercer's broken his oath with Nocturnal and defiled the very thing he swore to protect.
Nocturnal's a Daedric lord. Thieves and temples, it just doesn't add up. I think that's a quote from an Indiana Jones movie, Temple of Doom.
I felt the same way when Gallus first revealed these things to me. I think given time you'll understand what I mean.
I'd understand better if less mystery was involved. It kind of directly hinders the understanding.
As a Nightingale, I've been sworn to secrecy regarding the Sepulchre. I know the guild doesn't do much to foster faith, but I'm going to have to ask that you continue to trust me.
Eh, of course, of course. Very well, we do it your way.
I'll make for Riften and scout the situation. See if I can discover what Mercer's up to. When you're ready, meet me at the Ragged Flagon.
The Ragged Flagon? Oh, she's gonna stroll right in there, huh?
I wanted you to have this. It belonged to Gallus.
Reward.
But given the circumstances, I think he'd approve.
She's gonna give me a reward. Okay, I'll put whatever you haven't handed me yet to good use.
If the guild isn't willing to listen to reason, you might have to.
What does that mean? Oh, I might have to put this to good use. I might have to fight the guildies. Ooh, that's a kind of scary prospect. Okay, let's take a look at this this item. Nightingale blade? Yes. A dagger, 37 damage as compared to my 79 and 76, so tiny amount of damage, that's because it's a dagger. Absorbs 20 points of health and 20 points of stamina, and then telling by this little shaded out gray part, it takes quite a bit of the charge every time you strike with it. So just by the damage, I'm not going to be using that. It is a pretty good enchant, that's really strong, 20 points of both, but it would also run out really quick, and since I'm not using soul gems to recharge items right now, because I need them for enchanting, I would probably have that dagger out of charge the whole time, so it wouldn't really be worth using. Yeah, definitely gonna stick with my swords. If you had the 15 times backstab for daggers, that would probably be awesome.
Good.
Be a really awesome weapon. Matter of fact, I think that's the playstyle that is the most broken. So, let's return. We're going back to the guild now, right? Meet Carlia at the Ragged Flagon. This just started a new quest. Zip Pursuit! So, I'm gonna end this episode, and thank you all. Love you all. Goodbye.